Make sure you start off by having a good look through the introduction to basics matrix operations, how to add a matrix, how to subtract a matrix, multiplying matrices in particular, all right? Because what we're going to have a look at now is obviously the way in which our simultaneous equations can be solved using matrices, all right? So I guess the starting point is to be able to write the linear equations in matrix form, and we do that. There's my x values. Okay, so they're the leading values. My y values are the next two points. And we want to multiply x, y, because they're the variables. And we do that because, remember, with our matrix multiplication, it's this row times this column. So if I multiply that out, I actually do get 3x, because I get 3 times x, negative 2 times y, okay? And that's equal to, well, whatever the corresponding point is at the top. All right, so you need to revise your matrix multiplication in particular. All right, now, to solve the matrix equation, what we invariably do, we need to get x, y on its own. And so normally we would divide by the other term, yeah? But there's no such thing as matrix division. Instead, we multiply by the inverse. Because if I multiply a matrix by its inverse, I get the equivalent of 1. All right, again, that's in the notes. So the key is we multiply by the inverse of 3, negative 2, 5, negative 3. Now, to work out the inverse of a matrix, okay, and this is important, we have to work out the determinant, which is given by AD minus BC, all right, and then we work out 1 over it. And so then the inverse, I'll call it A inverse, is 1 over AD minus BC. And then we swap a few things around in our matrix. We swap the opposite corners and we change the sign. Now, for all intention purposes, it's not crucial. What's crucial for us, though, is AD minus BC. Because straight away, if AD minus BC happens to be 0, we have a problem. We can't work out the inverse and hence we can't solve the matrix. All right? And that's with this one here. The inverse of a matrix only exists if its determinant doesn't equal 0. All right? If it doesn't equal 0, we can get a solution. So what we want to consider is, well, if the simultaneous equations we have, if the determinant does equal to 0, what does that mean? And so if we think about, well, it means there's no solution. And what does it mean if simultaneous equations or two lines don't have a solution? Well, it can be one of two things. It can mean that my lines are parallel. All right. So if my lines are parallel, there can't be a solution, all right, because there's no point of intersection. Conversely, what if the lines were the same? Okay. If the lines are the same, they're one on top of each other, there is no unique solution either. There's an infinite number of solutions. And that's what a determinant of 0 can represent, one of those two scenarios. So if we want to move into solving simultaneous equations and trying to find out where, okay, my, for what values or when my equations are parallel or when they're the same, an equivalent way of doing that is to find where the determinant is 0. So let's have a look at this example, and I've solved it in two different ways. Let's start with the right-hand side first, all right? So I've got these equations here, 3x plus ky equal to 2, k minus 2 in brackets times x plus y equals k minus 1. So I'm looking for the k values that give me no solutions. So if I get no solutions, it means I'm looking for the k values that make those two equations parallel. So I could approach it, I guess how we might have last year, and even in year 10, if I rearrange the equations, so there's in green, actually I won't use green, I'll use blue, No, I won't use blue. I'm using green, sorry. There we go. There's my equation there, 3x plus k. Well, I take the 3x across, divide everything by k. So there's my y equals mx plus c. Clearly the gradient of that line is, little negative in there, negative 3 on k. Okay. What about my second equation? Y equals k minus 1 minus k minus 2x. I just take that k minus 2x onto the right-hand side. So the gradient of that line is given by negative k minus 2. So for these two equations to have no solutions, those two gradients have to be equal. Yeah. So if I solve those two gradients equal to each other, minus k minus 2 equal to negative 3 on k, bring my k across, multiply by negative sign through, I end up with this little quadratic equation there to solve. And if I solve that equation, I get k equal to 3 or k equal to minus 1. So what that tells me is if k is equal to 3 or negative 1, I don't get a solution. Okay? Now, by not getting a solution or not getting a unique solution, it means that my lines are either parallel or they're the same. So I've got to check. So if I put k equal to 3 into the equations, okay, so if I put them into the green equation first, if I put k equal to 3, I get y is equal to 2 on 3 minus 3 on 3, which is 1x. So I've got a gradient of negative 1. So there's my equation. If I put k equal to 3 into the blue equation, I get 3 minus 1, which is 2, minus 3 minus 2, which is 1. So minus 1x. So I get 2 minus 1x. So clearly, same gradient, different y-intercepts, so they're parallel lines, I have no solution. All right. If I check number 2 and put k equal to negative 1, because that was my other solution, again, substitute the values in, I get y is equal to 2 on k, which is negative 2 plus 3x. And if I put negative 1 into the blue equation, I also get negative 2 plus 3x. So in that instance, I don't get a unique solution. I get infinite solutions because the lines are on top of each other. Okay? So to sum up what I've discovered that if k is equal to 3, I get parallel lines, no solution. If k is equal to negative 1, I get the same line, which is infinite solutions. Okay? Which then leads on to part B. For what values of k does a unique solution exist? Well, k can be anything except for negative 1 and 3. Okay? Now, if I want to use a matrix approach to solve that, I set up my matrix. So there's my 3k, 2 for the first equation. 3k, well, 2 would be, I guess I should write it in. So the full equation would be xy equals 2. And my second equation, the k minus 2, the 1, equals k minus 1. So that's the full matrix equation. Okay, and you can see that down here on the calculator dump. If I work out the determinant, 3 times 1 minus k times k minus 2. Work that out. So the determinant is 0. If I want no solutions or infinite solutions, I get 3 minus k squared plus 2k. Rearrange, I get k squared minus 2k minus 3, which is the same quadratic equation. Yeah, and from there, everything else is the same. So I guess for me, the advantage of using a matrix approach is that I don't have to muck around too much with rearranging y equals to get this quadratic equation. I can just pop it into the matrix format, the AD minus BC to get the determinant, and I get the equation I need to solve for my no solution, infinite solution process. All right. Really, really important you check the k values, because sometimes they will both give you infinite solutions, sometimes they could both give you no solution, sometimes they give you one of each. You don't know until you check. All right, so it's really important you check whether the respective k values give you a parallel lines or the same line. All right, have a look at the next example.